Oh, these are the cells. I ain't behind, I'm over here on the side, kinda. I wonder where the control for these cells are. It's up here. Hi.
Wherever the Crimson Fleet go, we'll follow.
Okay. Stalkery. Alright.
Hello.
Hi. I want out.
The Vigilance is a state-of-the-art warship. Anyone that gets on the wrong end of her guns is gonna have a bad time.
Unless they like being shot, in which case they'll have a very good time. Requires computer. Oh, is that you waiting for me? I've locked you in. Ha 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 ha.
I think this isn't a Starliner cruise.
Where's the computer for this? I want to open that door. Fine, there's nothing else I can do out here. Docking port 05. Ship status. Unoccupied, ready. Clearance authorized UC ships only. Ship information, division captain, ship, ship status, NA. 7 as well. What port am I at?
Excuse me. I haven't seen my family in a while, but mission takes priority.
Can I use that? Find out which one my ship's at.
Ikande's on level 2. Try not to touch anything until he actually clears you.
Bit late for that. That's me. I'm at 01. Cora, Frontier, operational. Open this door before I have you killed.
All right, this is as far as I go. Take the lift up to Ops. Commander Ikande should be waiting for you. If you have any questions, save them for Commander Ikande.
And I'll give you a statement. Open that. I'll kill you. I'm surprised they didn't take our weapons.
Yes. What? I woke up in the middle of the night once and found Ensign Betty tinkering with some machine. Does she ever sleep?
You're asking me? I mean, I have no idea who she even is.
Hello.
The books aren't real. need it more than they do. Oh, Sarah's just checking stuff out. Stay clear when opening. What is this? What would be stored in there? Or who? Huh. Oh, that opened. You opened that? What are you doing? I didn't even know that was a door there. I'm a bad influence on her. Very bad influence. Fake books.
Hey.
Hey, hey.
Howdy.
Howdy doody. Lieutenant Jillian Toft.
Commander Ikande needs to speak to you. Immediately.
You alright? Okay then.
Okay. Hello.
This is how I respond to immediately.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Oh, Ensign.
I saw one of the Ensigns get an Alpha Centauri from Officer Petrosian the other day. The man takes his job very seriously.
Yeah.
Hey.
When they sit down, we can't... Wait. Oh.
Back in basic training, I had the record for fleet kills.
Fleet kills?
Pardon. Okay, hello.
Lost a bet to one of the officers. I've got mob duty now on my birthday. It's gonna suck. Excuse me.
You're excused. See, when I can't seem to, like...
Yes, what?
...highlight them. I cannot use this at this time. Oh, some books yes. Here. Of which I've already read.
Howdy.
Yes, hello.
Hello.
Yes, yes. Okay. There's more stuff over here. He can wait. In fact, it's preferable. To me, not him. Well, it's telling me to go this way. What's this?
I'm a bit busy at the moment, but we'll talk later, okay?
What is this thing?
I'm a bit busy at the moment,
okay.
But we'll talk later, okay?
Okay.
Hey. Commander Ikande is the heart and soul of UC Sysdef. I'd follow him to the ends of the galaxy.
I'm not sure he has a soul. Where did I go?
Yes?
Where am I now? I thought I was already on the ship.
Howdy. Maintenance crews are the unsung heroes of the Vigilance. Ensign Betty does a ton of work keeping things shipshape.
I've heard about hello. Ensign Betty.
Okay, hello. The Vigilance is our flagship. Where it goes, fleet run.
Pardon.
I want to navigate. Hi.
Yes? What?
Pretty cool. Captain's locker. Wait, where? This? Wait a second. Oh, that. Oh, it requires a key. Okay. Well, there's not much to see here. Pretty sweet ship. So it's really just... it's the bridge of the place.
shame the United Colonies built such an impressive ship for battle instead of using it for exploration.
Yeah, really.
Excuse me. Hey.
What are you doing with that? You having some problems with that?
I could have joined any division in the UC Navy. I chose Sister.
And now you are cursed by an item harassing you endlessly. That's a notebook. There's a notepad and a stylus on top. The Pickwick Papers? The Posthumous Papers of the Pickwick Club? Chapter 1, The Pickwickians? Sure, I have this, but the first ray of light which illumines the gloom and converts into a dazzling brilliancy that obscurity in which the earlier history of the public career of the immortal Pickwick would appear to be involved is derived from the perusal of the following entry in the transactions of the Pickwick Club, which the editor of these papers feels the highest pleasure in laying before his readers as a proof of the careful attention indefatigable assiduity and nice discrimination with which his search among the multifarious documents confided to him has been conducted. This is all one sentence. That's why I couldn't stand to read Charles Dickens. Charles Dickens' first book about a man who establishes a society whose goal is to travel and research human life became a phenomenon that established the author as one of the best of his day. Dover Beach. Ah, love, let us be true to one another, for this world, which seems to lie before us like a land of dreams, so various, so beautiful, so new, hath really neither joy, nor love, nor light, nor certitude, nor peace, nor help for pain, and we are here as on a darkling plain, swept with confused alarms of struggle and flight, where ignorant armies clash by night. So reads the final stanza of Matthew Arnold's stirring poem, Dover Beach. Carrie of the Cosmos? First published in the year 2301. Yeah, this does not seem familiar to me at all. Carrie of the Cosmos tells the story of Carrie, an overweight, lovable, unassuming young gal who unexpectedly gained cosmic powers and used them to defend the weak and underprivileged. The following is an excerpt from that work. Oh, really? Asked Carrie as she removed the terry cloth from tie from around her waist. Her bathrobe came open, revealing the unicorn pajamas beneath. Just then, the tie transformed into Carrie's signature weapon, a mighty spear called the unicorn's horn. Then maybe you should pick on someone your own size. Me. Carrie hurled the spear at the robber. After all, it was incredibly rude of him to try and rip off her favorite Terra brew when she was grabbing a latte, and pinned the unlucky larcenous lech's shirt to the wall. Wowza, said Carrie. Securing a new Atlantis just ain't what it used to be. That was interesting. The Light of Stars? Written in the summer of 1838, Longfellow's The Light of Stars is a stirring tribute to the cosmos before humanity had ever explored it. The following is a single, beautiful stanza. Within my breast there is no light, but the cold light of stars. I give the first watch of the night to the red planet Mars. The start of the unconquered will, he rises in my breast, serene and resolute and still and calm and self-possessed. Alrighty.
Hello.
Hi. Anything else around here? Oh, Officer Betty, I've been hearing about you.
I'm a bit busy at the moment, but we'll talk later, okay?
She's busy. She'll talk later, okay? Is it time to talk to this guy?
Pardon?
Have we left him waiting long enough?
Yes. What?
Have I been down here?
Excuse me.
People are awfully busy. All right, let's talk to them.
I'd like to brief you on the mission, so please, pay attention.
Do I have to?
Ah, there you are. Excellent.
Just talking to me.
Now that we've established your level of cooperation with us, I want to introduce you to your new home.
This is not my
this
new home.
This is the operations center of the UC Vigilance. SysDev's nerve center, dedicated to the destruction of the Crimson Fleet.
And this is me shooting my way off this prison ship. This is not my home. It is an impressive ship, but I don't see where I fit in.
Whether this ship is impressive or not, you're the key element that we've been lacking. We need eyes and ears inside the Crimson Fleet. Someone who can feed us information, evidence, and expose their weaknesses. The catch is that you can't just knock on their front door and ask for an application. Getting inside is going to take some finesse.
I assume you've chosen me because I'm expendable?
Let's get one thing straight right now.
I am.
While you're working for me, I'm going to treat you like one of my own. Whatever crimes you committed in the past no longer matter. You're now an agent of SysDev, meaning that it's my job to keep you alive.
Well, get me in a room with them and I'll talk to them into anything.
Good. I have just the right place for you to start. Our intelligence has managed to find a possible opening into the Crimson Fleet through Sersha Bowden, one of their contacts. She works for the Trade Authority in Sidonia, so you'll be using a container of Aurora we've loaded on your ship to get her attention.
Oh, have I seen her there? Is she the one who was really snarky with me? Aurora?
Aurora is a Class A controlled substance that's illegal to transport outside of Neon, a city on Volai.
No, what's her name?
Get caught with this stuff aboard a ship, and you're looking at some serious fines.
Where did you get the contraband?
That's classified. Suffice to say that the smuggler who was previously hauling it will be spending the rest of their life in prison.
Doesn't sound like an ironclad plan to me, though.
Well, it's the best we've got. Once you bluff your way into the Crimson Fleet, then the operation proceeds to evidence gathering.
You just bluff my way?
That's where my second-in-command, Lieutenant Gillian Toft, comes into the picture. She'll explain everything you need to know.
You tell me what I need to know. I don't want to talk to all these people. If this is the best plan you've got, we're both in trouble.
Well then, I suppose you'll just have to take your chances. In the meantime, I expect you to follow my orders to the letter. Remember, this entire operation rests on your ability to infiltrate the Crimson Fleet and bring us the evidence we need to take them down.
I'm guessing it's too late to back out of the deal.
At this point, whether you like it or not, you're working for me. Look.
That'd be not.
Before you begin, I want to make something perfectly clear. As an undercover operative for UC SysDev, you'll be expected to follow our code of conduct and ethics.
That's not fair.
Allow yourself to stray too far off the path, and you stand a good chance of spiraling out of control.
What? Spiraling out of control? What do you mean, stray too far off the path?
The Crimson Fleet doesn't follow the rules. They only abide by one theme: money. All of their morals and social graces fall by the wayside in pursuit of their greed. At first glance, this can appear quite enticing, so I'm warning you not to get lured into their trap. Think you can handle that?
So what is SysDev's code of conduct and ethics?
To put it simply, you can't go into every situation with guns blazing.
That's what I do.
Think before you act. Calculate what you're doing and pull the trigger only when it's absolutely necessary.
It's always necessary.
At the end of the day, your primary goal is taking down the Crimson Fleet. That's the greater good.
I don't exactly do very well following rules and regulations.
Well, you better learn quick. Otherwise, I'll start looking for someone to take your place. Anyway,
there's no one.
It's time to hand you over to Lieutenant Toft. She'll brief you about the details of the evidence-gathering portion of the operation. Now, get out of here, and good luck.
Do you have any more evidence about this Bowden person?
All we know is that she's been with the Trade Authority for years, which means she's been privy to some seriously shady deals.
More information, rather.
She's shrewd, and she's diligent. The only reason we were able to connect her with the Crimson Fleet at all was thanks to an informant. I'm afraid she's the best lead we've got.
You people are really screwed. Because you're saying that this whole operation rests on me, and if I don't do it, you'll somehow find someone else. Yeah, I don't think that's gonna be very easy for you. Tell me more about my expected behavior as an agent.
While you're running with the Crimson Fleet, you're undoubtedly going to be faced with some morally gray decisions. It's going to be difficult for you to weigh the consequences of pulling the trigger while maintaining your cover. Do what you have to do, but remember why you're out there in the first place.
What if I don't have a choice?
Then you do what you have to do. The Crimson Fleet has the potential to kill hundreds, even thousands of people per year. If it takes a few deaths to maintain your cover, then so be it. But only as an absolutely final resort. This is not a licensed killing spree. Understood?
I don't care if it's licensed or not. Maintaining my cover as a pirate and abiding by the law won't mix, though.
That's why I expect you to constantly seek alternative means to overcome your obstacles, rather than blowing holes in them. Look, I can see that you're struggling with this. So let me simplify this for you. If there's a route to your goal which doesn't involve killing innocent people, I'm urging you to follow that path.
Oh, innocent
people.
Use
your instincts. I'm certain you'll do the right thing.
I thought you men don't kill the pirates and other low-life degenerates. I'm not going to kill innocent people. But I would kill them, which you won't like either, I guess. What happens if I get arrested while I'm undercover?
For your own safety, nobody but myself and the crew of the Vigilance will be aware that you're working for the United Colonies.
So just be aware.
Basically, if you land in jail, you're going to have to deal with the fines.
You can't spring me out? Yeah. How do I maintain contact with you, then?
That's easy to answer. You don't.
But
we'll be monitoring your activities from the Vigilance and attempting to keep it within your vicinity. When you feel you've gathered enough evidence and at the completion of your assignments, head back here for a debrief. Beyond that, you're completely on your own.
All right, then, Stinker.
As you were.
Howdy. Yes?
Howdy, partner.
Okay. Hello.
Supposed to talk to... what's her name? Deep cover. Commander Ikande has outlined the parameters of my mission and has asked me to speak to his second-in-command, Lieutenant Jillian Toft. So she's... oh, she's here.
Excuse me.
Pardon.
You're excused and pardoned. Oh, now you'll talk to me?
What?
Not you.
All right. We don't have a lot of time, so I need you to listen up. While you're working undercover, it's imperative that you gather as much evidence as possible. If you find any records that look suspicious or incriminating, you bring it to me. Is that understood?
That's if I'm accepted into the Crimson Fleet.
You better make it, because Commander Ikande cashed in all his chips to get this operation off the ground.
I don't care about that.
I want data slates, computer downloads, handwritten notes. Hell, I'll take anything if it'll get those bastards thrown into the brig.
I'll grab some coffee cups for you. How about that? I'm confused. Are we trying to imprison the pirates or kill them?
Haven't you been paying attention? Our goal here is the complete eradication of the Crimson Fleet. In order to do that, we need to dismantle them piece by piece from within. If you bring me evidence, we can make arrests and slowly drain their resources. Think of it as a death by a thousand tiny cuts.
I'll just get out and do it all over again. Why not just kill them? Sounds like you have a personal vendetta against them.
You're damn right I do. That minor skirmish you had with them on Vectera was nothing compared to the death and destruction those pirates leave behind. If you've seen what I've seen, you'd understand why I'm pushing you so hard.
I don't want you to push anything. I'm no hero. I'm here because I had no choice.
I was hoping that you'd be inspired into thinking this is more than a punishment. It appears that I was wrong.
Yep, you're wrong.
I suppose we'll simply have to motivate you in a different way.
What?
Commander Ikande has authorized a credit disbursement for each piece of evidence that you return. As compensation for your efforts.
Eh. All I had to do was resist a little, huh? Why would you be paying credits during a military operation?
Well, that's just it. You're not career military, are you?
Not
and
anything
speaking
military.
Frankly, you're completely out of pocket during this operation. You'll be paying for your own supplies and other unexpected incidentals. So, if I were you, I'd stop asking questions and accept the compensation.
Well, you are speaking my language with the credits.
Commander Ikande came up with the idea. He was concerned you might not help us simply because it was the right thing to do. All right. We've loaded a container of Aurora into your ship's cargo hold. We're also providing you with a sample you can use to tease the goods.
Wait a second.
We've cleared your ship for launch. Proceed to Sidonia. Make contact with Saoirse Boden. And with any luck, she'll point you to the Crimson Fleet. That should do it. You're dismissed.
That's exactly what I was thinking. What if I get caught? With a container of Aurora in my cargo hold, they scan ships, don't you know that?
Don't worry, the container's been registered with UC Security, so you shouldn't have any trouble. Even if you're scanned.
It's registered?
Of course, if we find out you tried to sell it to someone outside the boundaries of this particular operation, well, I don't think I need to tell you the consequences of making that mistake.
Yeah, you'd come after me and I'd have to kill all of you. What happens to the people you arrest?
We'll be keeping them close at hand until this operation is complete. So, we'll be holding them in the Vigilance's brig. If you're feeling particularly ruthless, you could always head down there and say hello. I'm sure they'll be thrilled to see you.
They were empty. Are there people there now? Tell me about your personal experience with the Crimson Fleet. I'm kind of curious.
Not really, no. I've learned to keep my personal experiences separate from the job.
Oh, just tell me. Well, that was evasive as hell.
Was it? Yeah, I suppose I tend to do that. Comes from having no one to talk to around this ship. That's to be expected, I suppose. The Vigilance isn't exactly the best place to have casual conversations. We have serious work to do. Let's just stick to the job at hand and concentrate on the mission. But, maybe we can talk about it some other time. Okay?
Okay. I wonder if I can use this as leverage in some way.
Let me know if you need anything else.
Yeah, my ship back. Pardon me.
Is there anything else I can answer before you proceed to the next phase of your mission? If you have any questions, now's the time to ask.
I asked him.
You have your orders.
Give me orders.
Howdy.
I feel restricted by stinkers. Will you talk to me now?
Oh, hello. I don't think we've met. Are you by chance new here?
I'm not here. I'm just... And my name's Coria. Nice to meet you.
Wait, I know that name. You're that dangerous ex-convict everyone is talking about.
Mm-hmm. Well, briefly convict.
I'm not scared of you. My godmother was a member of the Strikers gang, and you're not even half as scary as her.
The who gang?
My name is Javanta. I'm an ensign with the maintenance and robotics team. And just between you and me, I don't think you're dangerous. Do you?
Yes, I am extremely dangerous. I'm dangerous. I've killed people, sometimes for sport. Most times for fun.
So the rumors are true? But you can't be that bad if Commander Ikande chose you for this mission.
No?
I think he sees a big heart yearning for goodness inside you. And so do I. Anyway, It was very nice to meet you. If you want to talk some more, I will be here.
What are your duties here?
Oh, I'm part of the maintenance team that makes sure the Vigilance is operating smoothly. On the robotic side, I take care of the Model A's on the ship and make sure they're treated with respect and dignity. They are people, after all, just like us.
They are. Have you seen robots abused and mistreated?
Not here. With a drone, clients would come in and bring their robots for maintenance. And the condition these robots were in was appalling. Not to mention the way they were talked down to. Personally, I think the way you treat your robots says a lot about you.
Well, why had a robot? I tried to endure him. Yeah, I think we should treat robots the same way we treat all living things.
See? I knew there was something I liked about you. Machines are very dear to me. Think of it this way. How can we expect a robot to fight by our side if we won't fight for their right to exist? So I always do my best to treat them as my equals.
In a way, they're better than people, so... Why did you join SysDev?
It's a good question. It was what you'd call a minor moral crisis. I wasn't happy with my old job at Drone. I felt like my life was on an assembly line. Everything was about profit, and nothing had any real meaning. But then it occurred to me, if I'm so miserable, I could just leave. So one day I just did. SysDev is far from perfect, but our goal is noble. I can sleep soundly knowing my work will be for a cause that is just.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to talk to her because at least two people mentioned her, so.
All right then.
Hi. I want to get back to these cells
hello.
He was talking about. Now there's people in them.
Yes?
So I guess I'm free to go back to my ship now. Inaccessible. That's my one. What does it say? Cockpit? Just curious about these cells.
How's the pirating business?
I'm not a pirate, you stinker. Where are the cells? Looking again. that there's any people in them. There's no one in these cells. What are they talking about? Reminds me of the cells on Shield. Like Loki was in one of these. I think it just had a bed though. And a toilet. These guys have a full kitchen. There's nobody in them.
Hey.
Hey, it's for horses. So what's it say now? My first mission is to proceed to Sidonia and make contact with Seorshe, I'm saying that right, Bowden, at the Trade Authority. You say Sistef has provided me with a crate of Aurora as a buy-in to the Crimson Fleet. So they put it on my ship, right? So that's nothing I have. Aurora sample. Oh, I have it. It's been registered.
Hey.
Which one? Wait. Over here, right?
My crew position.
Is that your crew position? Burden of proof. I've been tasked by Lieutenant Jillian Toft on the UC Vigilance to find and bring back any evidence pertaining to Crimson Fleet-related illegal activities. Audio logs and test logs would be especially helpful in bringing them to justice. Proceed to Sidonia. Well. That was a rather unexpected turn of events. What? I forgot what I was originally going to do. Oh, return to Jean. I'll do that too. I'll return to her and then talk to whoever there. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.